Heat energy. The early man discovered that rubbing two solid stones together started fire. Since that discovery, man could not live without heat or fire. Let's look together at how heat is transferred. To understand how heat is transferred, let's carry out the following activity. Activity 1. The transfer of heat. Steps. Number 1. Bring a jar containing some water and measure the temperature of water using a thermometer. Number 2. Heat some metallic balls using a Bunsen flame and measure the temperature of the balls. Number 3. Put the hot balls inside the water and measure the temperature of both the water and the balls. In the figure, you can observe that the thermometer reads 75 degrees in the hot water container and 15 degrees in the cold water container. In the container where both balls are mixed, the thermometer reads 45 degrees. Conclusion. The heat is transferred from the body with higher temperature to the body with lower temperature as they touch. Heat transfer continues until their temperatures are equal. Choose true or false. When we touch a cube of ice by hand, the temperature is transferred from the hand to the ice cube. Well done! It's true. Activity 2. Particles, movement, and temperature. Steps. 1. Put a number of metallic balls in a plastic cup as shown. 2. Record the temperature of the metallic balls by a thermometer. 3. Place an upside-down identical plastic cup on top of the first one and fix it with a sealing tape. 4. Shake the cylinder you made of the cups several times, 20 to 30 times. Then remove one of the cups and measure the ball's temperature. What do you observe? The temperature of the balls increased. Explanation. 1. As the balls were shaken, their speed increased. This increased the ball's kinetic energy and therefore increased their temperature. 2. The more the balls are shaken, the higher their temperature gets. Conclusion. 1. The motion of particles and their friction together caused their temperature to increase. 2. The temperature of particles is directly proportional to their speed and hence to their kinetic energy. Choose true or false. When the particles move and rub on each other, their temperature decreases. Well done. It increases. Activity 3. Transformation of mechanical energy by rubbing friction into heat energy. Steps. 1. Turn a bicycle upside down. 2. Turn the pedal as fast as you can. Then pull the brake firmly. 3. Touch the wheel immediately after it stops. What do you notice? Observation. The temperature of the wheel and brake is high. Explanation. The friction between the wheel and the brakes led to their temperature increase. Conclusion. Mechanical energy is transformed by friction into heat energy. From what has been mentioned, we can define heat energy and temperature as follows. Heat energy. It is a form of energy that is transferred from a high temperature object to a lower temperature object upon touching. Temperature. It indicates the heat status of the body and accordingly the direction of heat transfer to or from the body as it touches another. After studying how heat is transferred, let's study the ways in which it is transferred. Ways of heat transfer. Heat is transferred from objects with high temperature to objects with lower temperature in three different ways: conduction, convection, radiation. First, heat transfer through conduction. Activity 4 will illustrate conduction of heat. Steps. Hold a metallic spoon in your hand and use it to stir a cup of hot tea. What do you notice? The spoon end held by hand gets gradually hot. Explanation. Heat is transferred gradually up the spoon from the end dipped in tea to the end held by hand. Conclusion. Heat is transferred by conduction through some solid objects from one end to the other. Choose the correct answer. Heat is transferred by conduction in wood, glass, plastic, or iron. Well done! Iron. Transfer of heat by conduction is the transfer of heat by touching through some solid objects from the higher temperature end to the lower temperature one. Knowledge of heat transfer by conduction led to some applications that man uses in everyday life. These applications include 1. Manufacturing of cooking pots and heating containers from copper or aluminium, as they are good conductors of heat and heat is transferred through them very quickly. 2. Some windows are made of two layers of glass separated by air, and this is to prevent heat transfer to the outside during winter or to the inside during summer. Choose true or false. Heat is transferred by conduction in water. Well done! It's false. 2. Heat transfer by convection. Heat is transferred by convection as shown in the following activity. Activity 5. Heat transfer by convection. Steps. 1. Put an electric heater in the middle of a room. 2. Turn the heater on. What do you notice? The air of the room gets gradually hot. Explanation. When the air near the heater gets hot, its density decreases. It rises upwards and is replaced by cooler air of higher density that also gets heated. So it rises and is replaced and so on. The cycle of air current continues until all the air filling the room is heated. Conclusion. The heat is transferred by convection through air by the rising currents of heated air and the descending currents of cooler air. Note that heat is transferred by convection in liquids in the same way it is transferred through gases. Definition of heat transfer by convection. It is the transfer of heat through gaseous and liquid media. Heated particles of less density of the medium rise upwards and cool particles of higher density descend downwards. Choose true or false. Heat is transferred in liquids by conduction. Well done! It's false. Choose the correct answer. Heat is transferred in water by conduction, convection, radiation, or convection and radiation. Well done! Convection. Heat transfer in gases and liquids by convection has been used in several real-life applications, such as 1. Electric heaters used in winter for warmth. When the air near the heater gets hot, its density decreases. It rises upwards and is replaced by cooler air of higher density that also gets heated. So it rises and is replaced, and so on. The cycle of air current continues until all the air filling the room is heated. 2. The freezer is always put in the upper part of the refrigerator. The air close to it gets cold, and its density increases. So it falls downwards, replacing hotter air of less density that rises upwards to get colder, and so on. The rising and falling of hot and cold air currents continue, keeping a low temperature inside the fridge. Choose true or false. The freezer is in the top part of the refrigerator. Well done, it's true. Third, transfer of heat by radiation. Heat is transferred by radiation, as will be shown in the following activity. Activity 6. Heat transfer by radiation. Steps. Stand outdoors on a sunny day. What do you notice? You feel hot. Conclusion. Heat is transferred from the sun to earth without need for a material medium. This is called transfer by radiation. Question. Choose the correct answer. Heat is transferred to us from the sun by conduction, radiation, convection, or radiation and convection. Well done! Heat is transferred to Earth by radiation only. Notice that the sun heat is not transferred to us by conduction because the atmospheric air is a bad conductor of heat. The sun heat is also not transferred by convection because there is a huge vacuum between the Earth and the sun. No air in it. Definition of heat transfer by radiation. It is the transfer of heat from a high temperature object to a lower temperature object without the need for a material medium through which heat moves. Notice that the sun is not the only source of energy radiation, since all light sources radiate heat to their surroundings. Applications on heat transfer by radiation. 1. The charcoal grills are surrounded by polished metallic sheets. This is to reflect back most of the radiating heat to decrease cooking time. 2. We wear dark clothes in winter and light color clothes in summer. The dark clothes absorb most of the sun radiating heat, so we feel warmer, while the light color clothes reflect the radiating heat from the sun, making us feel less hot. Question. Choose true or false. We wear light colored clothes in winter. Well done. It's false. Dear students, now that we have learnt together how heat energy is generated and how it is transferred, let us learn about technology and the heat energy in real life. There are many technological applications based on heat energy. Some of them depend on everlasting sources, like the sun. Others depend on non-renewable resources, like coal and petrol. And others use renewable sources, like electricity. Despite the importance of all such applications, many of them are very harmful to the environment and became major sources of its pollution. The following table shows some of the technological applications that are related to heat energy. Technological applications. Impact on the environment. Its energy resource. Type of energy resource. The electric heater has no impact on the environment. Its energy resource is electricity. Type of energy resource is renewable. Charcoal heater. Fireplace. It is polluting. Its energy resource is charcoal. Its type of energy resource is non-renewable. Solar heater is non-polluting. Its energy resource is the sun. Its type of energy resource is everlasting. Electric water heater is non-polluting. Its energy resource is electricity. Its type of energy resource is renewable. Kerosene cooker. It is polluting. Its energy resource is distilled from oil, petroleum. Type of energy resource is non-renewable. Gas cookers are polluting. Its energy resource, gas, natural gas. Type of energy resource is non-renewable. Choose true or false. The electric water heater has a polluting, harmful effect on the environment. Well done! It's false. Choose the correct answer. Among the environmental pollutants due to use of energy is the charcoal heater, electric heater, or solar heater. Very good! The charcoal heater. After studying all sources and forms of energy in this lesson and the previous ones, we find that the distinct energy form that is different from any other is the solar energy, as the sun is the main source of most forms of energy on the earth. However, you have to note that solar energy is not the source for the following energies. 1. Nuclear energy. 2. Earth gravity energy. 3. Earth core energy. Choose true or false. The sun is considered the source of nuclear energy. Well done! It's false. A summary of lesson 3. We studied in this lesson that the heat moves from a high temperature object to a lower temperature object upon their contact, and that mechanical energy is transformed into heat energy by friction, and temperature increases as the speed of particles' motion increases. We also learnt that the heat energy is a form of energy that transfers from a high temperature object to a lower temperature object. And the temperature is the heat status of an object upon which the direction of heat transfer to or from the object is decided, as it gets in contact with another object, and it matches the kinetic energy of its particles. We learned that the ways of heat transfer are conduction, convection, and radiation. Conduction takes place in solid objects. Convection takes place in liquids and gases. And radiation takes place through gases and needs no material medium. We learned that the technological applications depending on heat energy include the heater, the cooker, the water heater, ovens. We learned that the sun is the main source of energy for most other forms of energy.